Here's how the site works at the moment. When you navigate to Witter, the browser makes a request for some HTML. Like all web requests, this goes via the browser's HTTP cache. And if there's no match there, it continues onto the internet. Then hopefully, the response makes its way back to the browser. The HTML the browser received tells it needs some CSS, so that's fetched. Once that arrives, we get our first render, a page full of content. You see, the initial set of posts are right there in the HTML. But at the same time the browser downloaded the CSS, it's also requesting some JavaScript. And when that arrives, it opens a WebSocket, a persistent connection that lets the server continually stream newer posts as they arrive. This provides the live updates, so the user doesn't miss out on a single piece of nonsense posted by the other users. In terms of the page's JavaScript, you'll find that in public JS main. The starting point is index.js, but all this does is load polyfills that some browsers may need, such as promises and the URL API, which we'll use a little bit later on. The main work happens in indexController.js. The constructor here is run for every page load. We have this post view, which helps us update the posts on the page. This toast view helps us display error messages. Hopefully we won't get too many of those. And then we open a socket connection. The OpenSocket method, well, as you might guess, opens the WebSocket. And the message event is fired when data is received for new posts to display. When new posts are received, OnSocket message is called. This method parses the data as JSON and passes the result to the post view. While the server is running, any changes you make to these files will be processed and built. I didn't want ES6 to be a prerequisite for this course, so I'm going to stick to ES5, but the build system uses Babel, so if you're like a cool kid from the future, feel free to use some of the latest JavaScript syntax. Oh, and I almost forgot, there's actually another server running on port 8889, so open that up. This gives you basic control over your connectivity to the server. Have a play with the settings, refresh the page and see how it responds. You'll see things are pretty bad in everything except perfect mode. And over the course of this course, we're going to fix the non-perfect cases.